怎么去连接上，然后你怎么一路走过来，是用什么样的心信念在走这一条路？因为您那一天提到您的父母亲在电视上看到你的时候那种惊讶的样子，我就觉得非常的好奇。
Maharaj， 你知道他的意思吗？你知道哈，在这里，在这里，在这里。
Well, you have to understand life in the West is different from here. That the family ties are not so strong.
首先 ，Maharaj 想告诉我们呢，其实西方的状况真的跟我们这边不太一样。在西方啊，那种家庭的结没有那么紧。
Young people often we go up, we grow up as soon as we can, we leave home and we live independently.
那就是像在西方啊，孩子从大学毕业啊，长大了啊。他们其实就很独立了，他们没有那么的执着依附那个家庭。
So I joined the Krishna Consciousness Movement in the 1971.
那我是在1971年啊，这个加入 ISKCON 的。
So at that time there was a lot of interest in the Eastern philosophy.And we didn't know much about it, but we were curious and we wanted to know more.
About what?
Eastern philosophy. Meaning,
Eastern, 东方的哲学
Meaning, what's in Asian culture, Buddhism, Hinduism, these things, they were all very unknown to us.
当时啊，对 Maharaj 他们当时的状况啊，其实东方的文化啊，像这个不管是佛教啊，啊这个佛教的这个方面的，还有印度的这方面的国家的文化，这些哲学对他们来说，他们真的非常的好奇，就对东方的东西很好奇。
You know, here in Taiwan, you grow up, you see temples all the time, you see monks all the time.But in the West, at least in the 1960s and 70s, we never saw those things. Monks in temples. There are 在西方国。
对，当时他们根本在西方，其实他们真的没有什么机会去看到像东方就这么多的这些庙宇啊，这些僧团啊，对他们来说真的是很神秘、很好奇的一件事情。在当时，马尔说是1960年代、70年代的时候。
And so some Swami started to come to the West.
那就是开始啊，有东方的 Swami 哈，就是来到了西方。
There were people coming, and the Beatles were famous, and they were taking. They had a guru.
那这个当时的披头士真的是太有名了。红透半天边，然后他们听人们听到说，哦，他有所谓的他的灵性导师 Guru。
And there was a lot of news in the news. There was a lot of things about gurus from India.
所以因此当时就很多的报道，就是都在报道说来自于印度的 Guru 这方面的。
And so naturally, I was reading books about different gurus.
所以他们就开始来读很多的关于所谓的孤儒的这方面的书籍，他们就开始涉猎。
Read about the teachings and what they were doing.
然后就开始来好奇，想知道这些师父们他们到底都是在教导什么，他们在做些什么。
So then, one day I happened to go to a store and I found the Krishna book and I was very attracted by it.
那有一次呢 Maharaj 就在书店他就找到了这本书叫 Krishna Book Krishna 快乐的泉源这本书他立刻就受到吸引
So I would you know I bought the book and took it home and、when I brought it home I showed my friend and he said well he had a book by the same person
好所以 Maharaj 就把那个书啊他就买回来结果他真的看着发现竟然他还有另外一本书是同一个人写的、
And so that was, we were very interested and we both started going to the temple there was a temple already opened in London
那当时呢在这个伦敦呢已经有这个帽子还是戴着好了
我有一个跳过已经跳过来了 So the devotees had come to England and they opened the temple
然后当时呢奉献者其实已经来到了伦敦而且已经有了庙有伦敦的庙
And so we decided we have to go and see this is the temple
所以马尔当就想说哦那我应该去看一看这个庙是怎么样
And so we both started going to the temple
所以、人们就开始去这个伦敦的庙去参访、
At that time, the devotees who were staying in the temple, they were all young, and they were all English people.
那当时住在庙里的奉献者呢，他们其实都是英国人，而且他们都非常年轻。
Oh, there was one Indian man.
可是有一个是印度人。
He was a little bit older.
那他比这个英国的那些奉献者还年长一些。
So I was puzzled. I thought, oh, this is some unusual. Even an Indian person is joining.
所以当时他就觉得这个很特别，竟然会有所谓的印度人啊来到这个英国的庙。
Everyone else, they were young British people.
其他的人都是很年轻的英国人。
So, you know, I used to go to the program every evening.
那当时呢我每天晚上都会去庙里参加活动
They had an arti every evening and after the arti they would speak from the Bhagavad Gita
那每天晚上都会有 arti 崇拜仪式然后之后就会讲述薄伽梵歌
So I'd heard of the Bhagavad Gita and I tried to study it before when I was a student
那当 Maharaj 还在念书的时候，其实当时他就有读过《薄伽梵歌》。
So I started to come every evening and attend the program.
所以后来我就每天晚上都会来庙里参加活动，
and we'd have,
参加课程。
We'd have a very ecstatic arti every evening.
那每天晚上呢，就觉得那个活动真的就让人觉得很狂喜。
Yeah, we would chant, we would do that. We had deities. There was Radha, big marble deities, Radha, Landanishwara.
那就是伦敦的庙里呢，有大理石的那个神像啊，Radha, Landanishwari.
And we had also Jagannath Baladev Subhadra.
有 Jagannath Baladev Subhadra 的神像。
And there was only one lady. She was French.And she was the Pujari.
然后就是只有一个祭司，她是来自法国的女祭司。
And we would do arti every night, and the devotees would chant, and we would chant.
当时每天晚上不是都做 arti 对不对？然后大家每天都很狂喜， 他就一直唱诵，大家一直舞蹈这样子，非常开心。
You know, London always is cold and wet. It was so nice to go into the temple with such a different atmosphere.
所以马拉就说，英国的天气啊，它就是阴冷潮湿，那种很阴霾的那种感觉，所以他觉得，哎呀，能够每天到庙里，那里的氛围真的感觉真是太美妙了。
So I started going regularly in the evening.
所以我就每天晚上都定时的都会去庙里。
Then one devotee said to me, he said, you know, you can stay overnight. We have a program in the morning.
接着就有一个奉献者告诉我说，哎，其实你知道吗？你可以住下来过夜，因为我们还有早课。然后他就说，可是我是有工作的，我要工作。他说没有关系啊，你就留下来过夜，然后早课完之后你再去工作啊。
So I started staying in the temple and we go to the morning program and I go to work and they keep me prasadam and then I come home and eat prasadam.
就这样被拐进来他就真的就听他的话，就是真的是晚上留下来，然后一早上完早课之后然后再去工作，而且他们还说我们会帮你留帕沙达，所以晚上回来吃帕沙达，结果晚上回来就继续晚上的晚课。
So I was doing this for a few weeks, and then they said to me, you know, you can give up that job.
结果马尔就这样持续了几个星期，就按照这样的 routine 这样做哈，这样很规律的这样子。然后后来就奉献者又跟他讲说，你知道吗？其实你真的可以住下来。你可以放弃你的工作没有问题，就直接跟他这样说。
We have a lot of things to be done in the temple.
我们庙里真的有很多事情可以做。
Yeah,
okay. 说 OK, 没问题，然后立刻就同意了，住下来，然后放弃了工作。
Yeah, so I got a job. I was working in the temple. And...They put me in charge of the incense business. We used to make our own incense.
那当时 Maharaj 呢就被安排啊，被庙里的奉献者安排，就是去负责做那个香的生意。因为庙里要营运嘛，对不对？要有一些收入，他们就在做那个香。然后 Maharaj 就是负责去制作那个香，
yeah,
管理那个部分。
We would make the incense and we would dip it in oil, you know, different.Oils like orange and cherry and strawberry. We would make incense which was flavored like that.
然后香也会有各种气味，对不对？比方说，橘子口味的啦，气味的啦，草莓的味道的啦，不同的味道都有这样。
People really liked it, you know.
人们非常喜欢我们做的香。
The Indian incense didn't have much smell, but our incense was very powerful.
那一般的香啊，它的香气不会那么的浓郁啊，然后但是就是当时在英国的庙里所做的那个香啊，他们用那个香油哈，那个做的那个精油做的那个特别的好，然后他们很受欢迎这样。
So we make it and we pack it. We had our own packet with a nice design, very nice.
然后我们也非常好的设计那个包装，把它设计得很美。
And that's how we supported the temple.
所以就是用这个香的这个生意啊，来维系着庙里。
Actually, some devotees had come from the USA, and they began the temple, and they also began the incense business.
那有一个就是来自于美国的。这个奉献者呢，他也开始了，就是有这个庙宇，然后也开始做这个香的生意。
And so, you know, he went back to America. He left the incense business for the devotees.
Left to the incense.
哎，那个人回去美国，所以我们的奉献是看继续我们做那个生意。
奉献者只是啊，
做卖香，卖
香。
嗯
卖香
卖到美国吗？
美国开始在美国开始做香呢，他从美国来英国教我们做香。
哦哦，他说从美国来英国教大家做怎么做香这样子。
嗯，我们也用那个油，我们放在一个小瓶，那个小
啊，
精油，
Essential oil， 就是精油，对，
嗯。你说这样我们可以为什么要，我们没有钱，没有，他们那个时候没有人给我们布施，
嗯，刚开始的时候，
刚开始肯定没有人给我们布施，那个时候 有一些印度人那个时候在英国，可是他们不太了解我们，他们不知道我们是真的还是假的。So like that, I became a devotee.
So Maharaj is just like that, became a devotee.
You know, before becoming a devotee, I wasn't even a vegetarian.
我在成为奉献者之前，我甚至于不是一个素食者。
I wanted to be a vegetarian.
但是我是有想成吃素。
But I didn't know how to cook, what to cook.
但是当时我真的不知道怎么吃素，要怎么吃，怎么煮这些素食。
I thought vegetarian only eat salad.
我以为吃素只能吃沙拉。
So when I came to the temple, then they had me in the kitchen and they taught me cooking.
然后我到了庙里之后，他们就把我带到厨房，就看他们怎么做饭。所以我就学会了，就是怎么成为素食者，怎么来吃素。
I didn't think I would stay very long as a the function. 我没有想我可以做 function 的那么长时间。
当时没有想到他可以做奉献者那么久。
Krishna pin mo.
Krishna pin mo.
Prabhupada, you know, they were always telling me, oh, Prabhupada's coming.
他们就一直奉献的一直告诉我说，虽然 Prabhupada 就快来了，他快来了，他快来了。
And so I was like, oh, yeah. I didn't really know.
我根本搞不清楚，他讲谁？然后不知道他是谁，他们就一直讲虽然 Prabhupada 快来了。
But finally Prabhupada came, and then, you know, he came and we all got initiation.
终于释迦牟尼来了，然后我们都得到启迪了。
And Prabhupada never really spent any time with us. He would give class every day.
释迦牟尼其实没有给我们很多的时间，然后但是他在的时候，他每天都给我们上课。
Sometimes in the mornings we could go for a walk. Sometimes with Prabhupada.
有时候早上我们会跟 Srila Prabhupada 去清晨漫步。
But Prabhupada was, you know, he was in his 70s and he was very learned and very knowledgeable, and I didn't know anything.
那当年 Srila Prabhupada 他都已经是七十高龄了，他是那么的已经在他的迟暮之年，然后他是那么的博学哈。博闻广见的一个人。
So I didn't really say much to Prabhupada. I just tried to hear from him.
所以其实我根本就是没有什么机会去接近他，我只是一直想办法去聆听关于Srila Prabhupada讲的。
Because I was just so new and I was coming out of the material world and I didn't know anything.
那我呢，就是真的就是从物质世界啊，就是步入了 Krishna。我当时什么都不知道。
So Prabhupada was just coming, and he was happy to see young people joining the Krishna conscious movement.
嗯，所以当时释迦牟尼看到他们这些年轻的一代加入了ISKCON， 他当时是非常高兴，注入了心血。
And he gave us initiation.
嗯，释迦牟尼就给了我们启迪。
Yeah, we were about maybe 15 people. We got initiation.
我们当时大概有15个人接受了启迪。
嗯 ，Prabhupada wanted to make sure we could say his pranam mantra.
嗯。那释迦牟尼他希望我们能够来就是念他的顶拜祷文。
Yeah. When we came for initiation, Prabhupada would sit in the Vyasa San in the temple room, and we would come and offer our obeisances one by one.
嗯，当时释迦牟尼他就住在庙堂里的那个 Vyasa San， 好，然后我们就一个一个向走向前来顶拜。
And we would give a, and then Prabhupada would say, "Say my pranam mantra out loud."
嗯，然后释迦牟尼他就会要求说，就是接近他走向来的人，他说你要大声的念出我的顶那个给我的顶拜祷文。
嗯 ，So we would say the pranam mantra, and then we get up, and then say, "What are the four principles?"
然后我们就会念顶拜祷文之后起来，那释迦牟尼就会问我们说，那你要遵守什么原则啊？
And how many rounds you're going to chant every day?
你每天要念几圈呢？
And then you say, okay, your name is. And he gave you the
name. 然后他就说，好，现在你得到了这个名字什么什么，就把念珠给这个奉献者。
And we would offer obeisances and go back and sit down.
嗯，所以那我们就在顶拜然后就完成了这个启迪的仪式。
So, you know, what happened was that.The next day, Prabhupada called the temple president to his room.
嗯，那第二天呢，释迦牟尼把这个庙长叫他到他的房间来。
The temple president, he'd actually come from America.
那这个庙长其实是来自美国。
No, you know, we were all new in England. Someone from America had been a devotee 2 or 3 years, you know.He was quite senior.
嗯，那就是那个美国来的那个庙长，那个奉献者，其实他是很资深的，他来了2-3年的时间。
对，已经过奉献服务，已经过3年的奉献服务，在美国开始。
哦，
所以他来到英国，他是一个奉献者，因为他是3年的奉献者。
3年吗？
嗯，
3年。
那个时候我们接着临江奉献就哇3年奉献很长时间我们都尊重他So he was the temple president
他是庙长
So Prabhupada called him to the room He said you know yesterday I gave initiation to 15 of your men
所以释迦牟尼就跟这个庙长讲，你知道吗？昨天呢、啊，我给你的是15个人启迪，你知道吗？嗯。
And he said none of them gave me any donation.
他说竟然没有一个人给我捐款，没有一个人给我捐款。
And the temple president said yes, Prabhupada, they don't have any money.
然后这个他庙长就跟释迦牟尼说：“你都没有任何钱。”
他们都没有钱。
他们都没有任何钱。
嗯。We were all, you know, thank you. We were all full-time devotees.
嗯，他们都是全职奉献者，都没有什么钱。
You know, when I was working, I had a job. Yeah, I was making money. So when I joined the temple, I gave all my money to the temple.
因为我当时加入庙的时候，住进去的时候，我把我所有的积蓄全部都给庙了，我没有钱。
And they, you know, they have to pay the rent for the temple.
因为庙本来就要付租金，对不对？
And、
所以
need money for buying boga, for offerings for the deity.
每天庙里都是要供奉食物给神像啊，那些都是要钱的。
So, but I did everything. I had, you know.
所以我就把我所有的钱都给庙了。
Prabhupada said, this England, just see. He said, this England, he said, they took all the money from India. And now they don't have any money.
结果徐良爸爸说什么你知道吗？他说英国人呢、啊哦、就是拿走了印度的那么多钱，而他现在他们自己一无所有，你看他们自己现在都没有钱。英国人没有钱。
这是印度了。
So that afternoon we all went on Sankirtan, and whatever money we collected, we gave to Prabhupada.
所以他们那天下午徐徐爸爸讲了这个之后，下午他们就出去派书，出去 Sankirtan， 然后把赚的这个钱全部都献给徐老 Prabhupada。
那一天卖得好吗？
差不多。
差不多。
Usually, you know, just being with Prabhupada, I would just try to hear. If I say anything, it would just show my ignorance.
所以对于在虚拉爸爸面前呢，我只能够当一个聆听者，因为无论我说什么，我就只能够显露我自己的无知罢了。这段话好美。
我想请问 Maharaj， 就是说你进来之后有没有曾经有在念头想要离开过，或者是说还有就是说你需要泡泡让你有没有就是他什么样的最吸引你的地方让你继续留下来的原因是什么？
没有，我没有想离开，
没有想离开。
虽然有时候我也有困难，有时候困难，可是我没有想为他。
他想知道为什么？
对，就是还有就是虚拉帕帕是他哪个地方是最吸引你，让你有激发到你，然后想要继续走下去，还是你自己就本来就没有见到虚拉帕帕，你就想要留下来？
She would like to know what keep you in Krishna consciousness in ISKCON. Is it that, you know, before you saw Srila Prabhupada, you are already attached to Krishna consciousness?
Yeah.
Or after you, or anything from Srila Prabhupada is very attractive to you, very attractive, to make you develop so much strong faith.
I became a devotee after reading Prabhupada's book.
他是在成为奉献者之前，他就开始读虚拉帕帕的书。
Right, so reading Prabhupada's book, I was impressed because I'd read many other books of different gurus, but his books were the ones which made the most sense.
他读了很多 guru 写的书。但是虚拉帕帕的书是唯一他觉得讲得非常有道理的书。
The meanings were very clear.
因为虚拉帕帕的阐释真的是非常昭然若揭，非常清晰。
所以那时候你毅然的，就是说住到庙里的时候，你把钱也都把你的钱都一下子全部掏光送给庙里，那个当下，在我听的感觉就是说，非常的气绝呢。哎，那个当下是因为你已经了解到 Krishna 的想要有这个信念吗？
我让你知道他的意思吗 ？The moment you give up all your savings to the temple is because, 他已经完全
就是弃绝
yeah, 对 completely detached、
yeah.
不是
还有讲说的
是因为他完全弃绝还有讲
就在我的感觉是他就是 Maharaj 的心但是就是弃绝的心理是不是那时候已经对于 Krishna 的意识意念
you don't have any doubt at the moment already everything this is your only you know path You want to surrender to Krishna.
Yeah.
You don't have other thoughts.
Mm.
对，他们当时马哈瑞说他没有其他的念头了，他觉得他就是交给 Krishna 了，所以他完全没有任何的依附。本来这个就是要给 Krishna， 他当时那个时候他不是莫名其妙，他觉得本来就是要把我所有的一切交给 Krishna， 他当时已经是这样想了，所以那种气绝已经不是困难了。对他来说，把他的东西就是他知道是 Krishna 的嘛，所以对他不是困难。
那么久，为什么还？我说我们学那么久，我们怎么还那么
执着吗？
还差那么多，
还那么依附，
对，还差那么多。
他说 ，How can we practice Krishna consciousness for such a long time? We are still so attached to our belonging. 为什么？马达达摩嘿，你想知道为什么？
对，马哈拉吉，为什么？
为什么？
Because you're still holding on.
因为你还不放手啊。因为你还紧抓着，所以就放不开了。就像抱着树，放开我，放开我。
Yeah.
对，马哈拉说对啊。
You have to let go.
要学习放下。
那 if you don't surrender to Krishna, then you surrender your money to the doctor, you surrender your money to the lawyer.
如果不把钱就是交托给 Krishna, 臣服于 Krishna, 那么你的钱就会交给医生还有律师。钱如果太执着，就会变成这样。把钱交给医师，交给律师打官司。
不会是给家庭吗？我觉得好像是因为马拉吉那时候还是大学，还年轻，其实他能没有家庭那方面依附，但是我们年纪越大，我们的执着依附就对家的依附就越深，其实就更难。
Yes, I agree. 我同意。
他同意你的说法。他那时候还没有什么。包袱那么多包袱，很单纯的一个人，然后对，然后所以不能拖啊，就是这样。
当然，我年轻的时候，我没有很多衣服。
现在更没有衣服。
衣服还是衣服？
现在衣服。
都是衣服。这个衣服也没有很多。
我听错了，我听错了。没有什么衣服，然后我听起来没有什么衣服、
啊、也没有，
就是真的也没有什么衣服，就是没有翻译错一样。哇，年轻的时候就没有什么衣服，那根本不是，马哈瑞不是一个普通的出身呢、啊。
对，很
清洁。那马哈瑞，你的父母本身有宗教信仰吗？
嗯，我们没有谈我们的父母，我们西方人，我已经出家了，我已经、
oh.
我上大学的时候一直没有回家。
他说一开始就说我们西方人对家庭的依附很浅，没有那个包袱，没有家庭包袱，所以这也是他们的一个优势，对，没有那么多家庭捆绑。只是在电视上看到，还是吓一跳这样子。所以，虚拉帕帕为什么是从西方开始？哈，其实都有一些原因。
马
拉
大概是什么时候来台湾开始？已经30年多。
30多年前，马哈拉吉就来过台湾。我们想一下，30多年前我们在做什么？
我就受三亚西的时候，1994年的时候，那个时候他们不是那个说你派我去台湾，但因为我一天在中国，我们在大陆在那边传教，可是在大陆我们不穿奉献色的衣服，我们只穿普通的衣服。
喂，
可是我接受sannyasi的时候，Tamal Krishna Goswami 认为你应该去台湾，这样你可以做一个sannyasi，你可以穿sannyasi的衣服。所以他派我去台湾，可是他也觉得很难。我觉得台湾那么难。
王大哥，你要睡着了。
他会住。
回台北太晚。
哦，
那你小心哦。
哎，等一下，那你们可不可以打包一点食物？不然会太饿了。
对，
你们打包一点食物，包便当。
有吗？那
不是少很多。对啊，真的少了啦。
打包一点东西。
秀，你看你要吃什么？
秀，你帮那个黄大哥他们打包两盒那个，不是两杯汤好了，热汤。
哦，